Our speaker tonight, competent Toastmaster Steven Lai, is our immediate past president, as we all know. He is an IT professional, and he used to work for a multinational company, which requires him to travel extensively. Of course, the company he used to work for is located in USA, and he was also graduated from USA, so he traveled to USA quite a fair bit. In addition to USA, he has also traveled to many other countries. He's practical, like absent, you know, every two weeks he will be traveling. So he makes sure he doesn't travel during Il Tamas. He has been to many parts of the world, especially in Asia and Australia. And he has now planned to, I'm sure, he's now planning to conquer Europe, Africa, Latin America, and Antarctica. Right? So throughout all his travel, competent Toastmaster Steven Lai has encountered many different cultures, and tonight he's going to share with us cultural shock or shocking cultures. Toastmaster, competent Toastmaster Steven Lai, cultural shock or shocking cultures.
About 15 years ago. At the time, India was still very much undeveloped, and it was his first trip to India for business. After a long journey flight, he was so tired, he just wanted to check into the hotel and go to sleep. And at the reception, he just told the reception, please give me a morning call or a wake-up call, because he doesn't want to miss the important meeting the next day. So he was knocked out almost immediately and hit the bed in his bedroom. And about morning, when it was still dark, while he was still in his slumber lamp, suddenly he thought he heard something. And he thought he felt something. When he opened up his eyes, he was shocked. There's this big, burly black man with full of facial hair. Jai, wake up! Jai, wake up! That was his morning call. If you were me, I would have scared the living daylight out of me. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was his first culture shock in India. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
According to Wikipedia, culture shock is conditions where one experiences when exposed to different environment of different culture which he or she not adapted to. He could experience fear, anxiety, trauma, or discomfort. I had my first share of culture shock when I moved to the US to further my studies. It was not in USA which I actually experienced my culture shock. It was in Toronto, Chinatown, when I went there for a holiday. I had never been with so many Chinese before. It's like the whole place, 100% of the place will filled with Chinese. I think they're all from Hong Kong. And I was feeling very discomfort because they were loud, a little bit rude and rough. And I could almost immediately spot out who are the gangster or the so-called the Chinese mafia, because they dressed exactly like Zhao Yun-Fa, black glasses and long trench coat. No joke! And after 1 hour, I decided to really, I need to leave. It was really uncomfortable for me. Talking about Chinese, a friend of mine just moved to China to extend his work there. On his first day of work, he almost didn't get to go to his office. Why? Because when he pressed the lift button, he was standing there. As soon as the lift opened, the Chinese room go in already. He was still standing outside. And then went on a few rounds until a colleague asked him, what are you doing here? I'm trying to get into the lift, he said. So the Chinese colleague said, okay, let me help you. When the lift opened, everybody rushed in. The Chinese go, go. As soon as got in, of course, there's no second. personal space in China. Everybody was breathing into everybody's faces. Another phenomenon in China, cultural phenomenon in China, is spitting. I'm sure you know about how Chinese like to spit everywhere, anytime. According to my friend, it is almost a skill that you need to be perfected. And I'm sure that the Chinese is the best spitter in the world, because they've learned this through their martial art and all the kung fu and stuff. And he seriously saw this man in a shop. Sitting inside a shop, he could spit across 5 meters out into the street, into the trees, all into the trees. He was standing there, he almost did the Matrix move, boom! Projected out into the small drain. Marvelous skills, marvelous. And I saw this myself, that, you know that Chinese, when they spit already, the one thing they like to do is that they step on it and just do this. I don't know why, but it's totally, you know, disgusting. But this man, I saw him, who was walking very fast, bro. And he did a spit in front of him so fast, so quick, he just landed right in front, and without changing his pace or his strength, he could just, boom, wipe it off his shoes. Who could do that? Only the Chinese could do that. And my mother had a culture shock of her own when she went to Japan. She was shocked to know that in Japan, to experience the Japanese spa, they call it the onsen, you need to be stark naked, right? You're not given any towel to cover yourself. So, you know, you were only given a towel about this size. So the tour guide told her and the rest of the tour team, well, you could do a few things with this towel. Depending on which part you're shy, you just cover. You can cover the left side or the right side, but not one much use that. So maybe you want to cover the bottom side. Depending, you want it the front or the back, depending which way you're walking. Or, if you're really shy, then take this, just cover your face. That's the best thing. But if you are really, really proud about your body, you just take it and strain. Of course, I asked my mother, what did you do? She just ran, jumped into the pool, and never got out. Then until everybody left the room, then we should know. So, ladies and gentlemen, I don't think we could avoid culture shocks when we travel to a new country. Whether, you know, it is the wake-up call in India, the spitting habit of Chinese, or the cultural role or sense experience in Japan, you know, you can never be too prepared for it. So do your research online before you travel to a new country to avoid any embarrassing situations. If you want to, which I think we should as well, just be prepared. You know, sometimes our system needs that shock so that we can get out of our comfort zone. We are sometimes too comfortable and realize what's happening in the world. There's a lot more things happening in other parts of the world. So whenever you travel, ladies and gentlemen, make sure that you brace yourself and embrace the shocking cultures of others. Good night.